Time to build Joulescopes. I'm here at Custom Electronics, my manufacturing partner for building up the Joulescope units. We're going to be setting up the line to manufacture 25 beta units tonight. Hopefully we'll even build the first one or two, with the remainder tomorrow. They've been kind enough to let me check everything out so I can see how everything works. This is so cool. Let's check it out.
The process starts with applying solder to the circuit board. The first step with the machine is to inspect the circuit board and make sure it's aligned. Once it's aligned, it then pushes it up and then applies solder all the way across the surface evenly and smoothly so that it hits all the pads. It's now removing the excess solder, leaving just the solder inside the stencil, which matches perfectly with each of the pads that the parts connect. The board is then lowered, and then on the inside you can see it doing a visual inspection to make sure that the solder was applied correctly. If it wasn't, it'll reject the board and it can be washed and repeated. The board comes out and is then ready for the next stage, which is the pick and place machine. We're using a manual process for low volume prototype assembly, so we manually place the board inside there. This is a two-up board, meaning there's two Joulescope main boards on this. The pick and place machine is selecting its tools, and then it'll go and collect the individual parts and then place them on the board in rapid succession. The head that's moving back and forth on this pick and place machine can hold up to 8 individual components at a time. Now the parts are coming from reels. This is a tape and reel, for the most part, board. And the head travels over, picks up to 8 parts at a time from the reels, and advances the reels so that the next part is ready for the next time. We'll speed up to 8 times speed here. The board is nearly done, and we're going to be working on the last few components that are the larger components. Now the last two microcontrollers are going on. And that completes the pick and place process. The board is now ready to be reflowed. The solder has to melt to adhere and make good both mechanical and electrical connections for all the parts. It travels through this big machine and comes out the other side after it's been cooked, and then the solder has cooled and all the junctions between the parts have been formed. Thank you very much to Allied Component Works and Custom Electronics for making this video possible. We're going to take a look back. That's the oven, the reflow oven, the pick and place machine, and the solder stencil machine at the very end down here.
The Joulescope beta build was a great success. After the surface mount assembly, we installed the two through-hole components. We then installed the main board inside the chassis, along with the front and end panels, to form the complete Joulescope units. We now have a number of beta units that are all ready for early reviewers. I'll be launching a Kickstarter on February 19th, and the big challenge between now and then is growing the Joulescope community. I really need your help. Please start by liking and subscribing to the video by clicking down below, and then hop over to the Joulescope website, joulescope.com, to sign up for the newsletter. I envision a future where we change our batteries less often, we recharge our batteries less often, and in general we have products that are just more energy efficient. Joulescope, in the hands of makers, engineers, and developers around the world, can make this happen. If you know anyone who is interested in Joulescope, measuring current, measuring power, microcontroller energy consumption, please forward this information to them, joulescope.com and the Kickstarter on February 19th. Thank you for your help. And thank you for watching.